Welcome to a new chapter in biology where it deals with the strategies for enhancement in food production. Now, as the title says, strategies to enhance the production of the food. What was the necessary of increasing the food in India and the world? Okay, you can think over it. What is the purpose of production of the food? Why we need to produce lot of food, either it is from the plant source or from the animal source? This is because of population explosion. Increase in the population, it leads to increased demand for the food. As a result, the food, when the demand for the food increase, then ultimately the production also has to be increased. And how the production is increased? Mainly the production for the purpose of food is increased by two sources. One is plant source, second one is animal source. Plant source is nothing but it is from the agricultural sources. Animal source is from various types of domestic animals, along with that even other types of animals. So in this topic we are going to study with the plant part also, animal part also, and in the initial part we are going to study with the animal food productions, where we come across a heading termed as animal husbandry. So let's look at the various kinds of the food that are produced from the animals, and later on various different kinds and varieties of the food that is produced from the plants. So the heading comes animal husbandry. Now it is an agricultural practice of breeding and raising livestock. So animal husbandry, it deals with an agricultural practice where it's mainly used for the purpose of breeding as well as raising the livestock. Breeding is nothing but it is the process of reproduction to continue the generation, to continue the species, so that we can increase the number of animals. Livestock includes all the various different types of the animals that we are going to use either for our benefit or for the production of the food. Here in this topic, whatever the things we are going to discuss, it is mainly for the purpose of the food only. Okay, then that's why animal husbandry is also said to be it is the purpose of breeding as well as raising the cattle. Breeding includes the process of reproduction where we can increase the herd size of the cattle along with other livestock. Then what does livestock refers to? Livestock refers to group of various different types of animals that are commercially used, or they are used as food by the humans. So livestock, it includes cows, buffaloes, birds, mainly we call them as fowls, then rabbits, horse. Okay, sheep, goats, donkeys, etc. So all these represents the livestock. So here livestock, what exactly we mean by the livestock? Livestock are nothing but these are the animals mainly used by the man, and those includes all these things. So we have taken few examples here. Apart from this, the rest of the examples that that is mainly used by the man comes under the livestock only. Cow, buffalo, birds, rabbits, horse, sheep, goats, donkeys, all these together we call them as livestock. Because we are not maintaining them in single, we are maintaining them in group. What is the purpose? To produce the food. Okay, so what we are going to produce from the cow, from the buffaloes, from the sheep, from the goats. So mainly we are producing milk. So milk is produced from that. From the birds, eggs are produced. Then chickens, they are produced. So all these are the various different types of the livestock. Then apart from these, even we also use other organisms like catching of the fishes. Then shelled animals, those shelled animals belongs to molluscans. They might be the pila, even the oysters, pearl oysters that are consumed in the form of food. Then prawns, crabs, then apart from these we use even bees also, then silkworm, etc. What is the purpose of these fishes? They are used as food. Shelled animals, they are also used as food. Prawns, crabs, lobsters, all these are used as the coastal foods. Then honey bees, from which we are going to produce the honey. Then silkworm, from which we are going to get the silk. That silk is of commercial part. Even wool that we extract from the sheep, that is a commercial, where it is used to make the blankets. Now that means even apart from the livestock, we use other animals where it can be used in the form of food or in the form of commercial items. Okay, like the silk, wool, it is a part of commercial aspect. Okay, and most of these we use them in the form of food. Okay, then out of all these, if we come across the animals, then 70% of the world livestock population is in India and China. Look at this, most important. 70% of the world's livestock population is in India and China. Okay, that means our contribution is abundant, because our contribution of the population is also same, because almost China and India, they are the major populated countries of the world, and hence even we also rear all these livestock. Okay, so that's why, so 70% of the world livestock population is in India as well as China. So most of the livestock are maintained, reared, breeding is done, as well as even their number is also increased, okay, to produce the food. So with this, we are going to discuss regarding various parts. So first comes, in the animal husbandry we are going to discuss the dairy and dairy farm management. Then we are going to discuss the poultry. And poultry farm management. Then we are going to discuss the apiculture. Maintaining, rearing of the honeybees to produce the honey. Then we are going to fisheries. Okay, rearing as well as the capturing of the fishes. Now, dairy its main intention is to produce the milk, as you know it very well. Poultry, its main intention is to produce the egg as well as the meat. Apiculture, main intention is to produce the honey. Fisheries, main intention is the food. Okay, fish is used as food. Okay, so we are going to study the detail aspect of all these things. So today let's start with the first one, dairy, in the animal husbandry part. So in the animal husbandry we are going to study all these four things. So earlier silk, even the sericulture was there. Sericulture is nothing but rearing as well as maintaining of the silkworm, but that silkworm is mainly maintained and reared to produce the silk. But that silk is widely used in textile industries to produce all the silk items, silk saris, silk dhotis, all those things in the textile industries. But as far as the food part is concerned, now it has been not introduced here. So we are going to study these four. So dairy, poultry, then apiculture, fisheries. Okay, so first one is dairy. What is the purpose of maintaining the dairy farm and as well as the dairy farm management? So we are going to that dairy farm management at the end of this concept. So these dairy farms, mainly what we are going to maintain here, so here rearing of the cattle are reared for the production of milk. Okay, so rearing of cattle for the production of milk. Okay, it is a main intention of dairy farm management. Now in the dairy farm, what we are going to maintain? We are going to maintain the cows, we are going to maintain the buffaloes. Then apart from this, to a least extent we are using goats as well as sheep to produce the milk. But more valuable is of cows as well as buffalo milk only. Okay, so here as far as the dairy farm animals is concerned, we are taking these two. Mainly we are taking these two. Which one? Cow as well as buffaloes. Okay, now based on the cattle, we just categorize the animals into three types. Okay, first one, the animals that produce the milk. Second one, the animals which are used for work purposes. Third one, the animals which can be used for the purpose of work as well as for the purpose of production of the milk. Okay, so based on the utility, animals are categorized into three types, and those include, the first one is milch breeds. The second one is draft breeds. And third one includes dual purpose breeds. Okay, so milch breeds, draft breeds, dual purpose breeds. So let us study about the milch breeds. Now as the name says, what are milch breeds? Milch breeds, these are the animals which are meant for production of milk. The animals which are mainly meant for the production of the milk, they are said to be milch breeds. So here whatever we are discussing regarding the milch breeds, draft breeds, dual purpose breeds, it is an additional extra content out of your NCERT, okay, where you need to know in the dairy farm management. Because in the dairy farm management, if we don't know which are the animals that are used for the production of the milk, which are the animals that are used for the work purpose, then it becomes a lesser sense. So that's why we have taken all these three categories. Okay, then let's go for the examples here. If we look at the examples of the milch breeds, in the milch breeds we have certain examples, and those examples here we are including as Red Sindhi, Sahiwal. So whatever the examples I am giving, these are the examples of the cow breeds. Okay, so these are the examples of the cow breeds. Red Sindhi, Sahiwal, these are cow breeds that are used for the purpose of production of the milk. Okay, and they are Indian breeds only. Okay, now in the next one, let's go to the second one. Second one is a draft breeds. So these breeds or these animals are used for work purpose. Milch breeds, they are used to produce the milk. Draft breeds, they are used for work purpose, either plowing the field or pulling the bullock cart. Okay, mainly they are used for the work purpose. And here it includes examples. Let us quote the examples. Examples includes Amrit Mahal, Hallikar, Khilari. So all these are various examples. Apart from this, even many examples are there, like even Krishna Valley, okay, all these are the breeds of cow. Okay, so in the draft breeds we have Amrit Mahal, Hallikar, Khilari, Krishna Valley. And the part that I am going giving the examples here, they will be asked for your NEET compulsorily, which amongst the following is a breed of animal. Options will be given: Amrit Mahal, Taj Mahal, Jodh Mahal, innond yavado mahal kotirtar. Okay, so Amrit Mahal is not a mahal like Taj Mahal, it is a breed of cow, right? So this is regarding the various examples for the draft breeds that are used for the purpose of what? For the purpose of work. Let's go to the third one. The third one is dual purpose. Dual purpose breeds. So these animals are used for both milk production and work purpose. So they can be used for the production of the milk. Mainly the female animals are used to produce the milk, and the male animals, they are used for the work purpose. Then what are the examples for this? The examples for the dual purpose breeds, it includes Haryana, Ongole. Okay, many breeds are there, out of which We are discussing only few examples here. So dual purpose Haryana Ongol. Haryana is the name of cow breed and it is brought from Haryana region. Okay, so that's why the name. And the animal names which I have given, all these are the breeds of cow. All are cow breeds. Okay. So with this, let us go for the indigenous as well as the exotic breeds. So let's see the indigenous breeds. As the name says, what is the indigenous breed? Indigenous means Indian breeds, local breeds, desi breeds. So these are the breeds of our country. So these are the breeds of our country. Which is our country? India is my country. Okay, so they are called as indigenous breed. Breeds of India, Indian breeds, local breeds, desi breeds. Indian breeds, desi breeds, exotic breeds, videshi breeds, right? So here you can quote any example of this. Indian breeds, we have all this: Red Sindhi, Sahiwal, Amritmal, Hallikar, Khilari, Krishna Valley, Haryana, Ongol. Any two examples you can quote for this, because already I have given here, I am not mentioning here. Okay, so this is the indigenous breed. Then the second one is exotic breeds. As the name says, exotic. These are the breeds which are brought from other countries. What is the purpose? The main purpose is production of the milk. So these are the breeds brought from other countries. That's why they are said to be exotic breeds. Then what are the examples for the exotic breeds of cow? Let us talk the cow breeds. As you know it very well, so let's take the example here. The example is Jersey. Examples includes Jersey, then HF. You have heard about the HF cow. HF aakala anta karitivi. HF andre enu? Holstein Friesian. Holstein Friesian, in short we call it as HF. Then Red Dane, Brown Swiss. So all these are exotic breeds, breeds that are brought from other countries. Then from which country we have brought? Jersey is brought from New Island of Jersey in England. New Island of Jersey in England. There is an name of a place called as Jersey. From that place, our esra adak badati illa namu on Haryana aitla. Similarly, the Jersey is from New Island of Jersey in England. Allinda tagond bandirodha. It is a British breed. Okay, English breeds are called as British breeds. Okay, then Holstein Friesian, HF. HF, HOL, it stands for, it is a brought from Holland. It is a breed of Holland. Okay, then Red Dane, D, it stands for Denmark. It is brought from Denmark. It is a Denmark breed, Red Dane. So body will be reddish in color. Okay, so Red Dane. Brown Swiss, as the name says, Swiss, Switzerland. It is brought from Switzerland, right? So these are various different types of what breeds? Exotic breeds that are brought from other countries, different countries. Jersey, New Island of Jersey in England. HF, Holstein Friesian, brought from Holland. How to remember? HOL, Holland. Red Dane, D stands for Denmark, imported from Denmark. Brown Swiss, imported from Swiss, Switzerland. Okay. Out of these, do you know which is the world's highest milk producer? Which is the world's highest milk producer? Yes, it is yavudu Jersey no HFO. It is HF. Okay, you can note it down. World's highest milk producer is HF, Holstein Friesian, more than Jersey, where it will give around 25 to 30 liters of milk per day. Per day, ಒಂದು ದಿನಕ್ಕೆ 25-30 ಲೀಟ್ರ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಇಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಫೀಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ಏನು ಫೀಡ್ ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಮೇಲೂ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರೇರ್ಡ್ ವೆಲ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ಡ್ ವೆಲ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಹೈಜಿನಿಕ್ ವೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಎಚ್ ಎಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸರ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ HF comes Jersey and others. Okay, Jersey next lead olagade iruvantadu. So this is regarding the exotic breeds of the cows. So indigenous breeds as well as exotic breeds. Okay, now till now we have discussed regarding various different types of breeds of the cows. Now let's go to the few examples of the buffalo breeds. If we compare the cow as well as the buffaloes, the production of the milk is more in case of the cows rather than the buffaloes. So buffalo breeds, okay, so these buffalo breeds, it includes the native Indian native, where we call it as Murrah, Mehsana, then Nagpuri, Neeli Ravi, Badauri, Surti. Okay, so look at the names of the buffalo breeds here. So Murrah, Mehsana is there, Neeli Ravi is there, Nagpuri, Badauri, Surti, then Jafarbandi, so all these are various different breeds of buffalo. All are buffalo breeds. Murrah, Mehsana, Nagpuri, Neeli Ravi, Badauri, Surti, Jafarbandi. Out of these, remember at least 2 to 3 names. Okay, 2 to 3 names, right? So out of these, Nagpuri, brought from Nagpur. Idakke usually Mauli emme endu karitara atha Gauli emme endu karitara, udu kombi irthava. Resistant variety, all these are Indian varieties only. Exotic now tandilla, yakandre exotic milk production kadime ada. So that's why here also in the Indian variety. So if we compare with the cow as well as the buffalo, now look at these cow varieties, their milk production is high than the buffaloes. But we can differentiate the milk of the cow as well as the buffalo. Cow milk, it will be yellowish in color. Buffalo milk, it will be whitish in color. Fat is highest in which milk? Buffalo milk or cow milk? As you know it, fat is highest in the milk of buffaloes than the cow. Cow milk, its milk content is fat content is less. Okay, that's why generally the cow milk is given for the infants, right, where the milk can be digested, and milk is said to be the complete diet because it contains all the things. It contains proteins, vitamins, minerals, calciums. Okay, so all these things are there. right, along with the fat content. So buffaloes and their breeds, right? Now you have to remember all these things, okay? So these are the breeds which are not mentioned in your NCERT. Out of the NCERT, I have given this. So with this, we have the last heading of the dairy farm management, and the last heading is how exactly the dairy farm has to be managed. And regarding the dairy farm management, let me discuss it in the next session. Thank you.